reading from the letter of Paul to the Galatians. Now I say that the heir, as long as he is a child, does not differ at all from a slave, though he is master of all, but is under guardians and stewards until the time appointed by the father. Even so, we, when we were children, were in bondage under the elements of the world. But when the fullness of the time had come, God sent forth his son, born of a woman, born under the law, to redeem those who were under the law, that we might receive the adoption as sons. And because you are sons, God has sent forth the spirit of his son into your hearts, crying out, Abba, Father. Therefore, you are no longer a slave, but a son. And if a son, then an heir of God through Christ. The gospel according to Luke. And Joseph and his mother marveled at those things which were spoken of him. Then Simeon blessed them and said to Mary, his mother, Behold, this child is destined for the fall and rising of many in Israel, and for a sign which will be spoken against. Yes, a sword will pierce through your own soul also, that through the thoughts of many hearts, that the thoughts of many hearts may be revealed. Now there was one Anna, a prophetess, the daughter of Phanuel, of the tribe of Asher. She was of a great age and had lived with a husband 7 years from her virginity. And this woman was a widow of about 84 years, who did not depart from the temple, but served God with fastings and prayers night and day. And coming in that instant, she gave thanks to the Lord and spoke of him to all those who looked for redemption in Israel. So when they had performed all things according to the law, they returned to Galilee, to their own city, Nazareth. And the child grew and became strong in spirit, filled with wisdom, and the grace of God was upon him. Thus is the gospel of the Lord. Let's start with our prayer for vocations. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. Let us ask God to give worthy priests, brothers, and sisters to his holy church. O God, we earnestly beseech thee to bless this diocese with many priests, brothers, and sisters who will love thee with their whole strength and gladly spend their entire lives to serve thy church and to make thee known and loved. Bless our families, bless our children. Choose from our homes those who are needed for thy work. Mary, Queen of the Clergy, pray for us. Pray for our priests and religious. Obtain for us many more. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. Well, I hope you had a good time at Christmas with family. I know some people couldn't get together this year because the new variant has people a little bit cautious, I guess. Anyway, I was able to get together with my family, most of them. Some weren't able to come, and it was a lot of fun. And I have a hilarious family. But today, we look at the Holy Family, who on this would be the presentation, right? This is the fourth decade of the Joyful Mysteries. But this is the day that they brought him to the temple, and everybody was filled with awe with the child. And it was Simeon who said at that time, he will be, in this particular English translation, he didn't say the exact words, but in most translations it's, he will be a sign of contradiction. In the Latin we heard, "Signum cui contradicitor." He'll be a sign of contradiction. Now, we can see that faith, religion, faith in Jesus Christ can be something that is off-putting for some people. They don't want that in their life. There's a parish that I came to understand that got a holy priest assigned there, and they complained to the bishop that
we don't want this Jesus thing in here. And so we can see we're living in very challenging times right now. I had emailed my brothers and sisters. I have five brothers and sisters. I used to have six. Joey passed at about 22 years old. Anyways, I have five brothers and sisters, and I emailed each one of them, and I said, you know what? I want to pray for everybody. You know, not that I think you're big heretics or anything like that. I just want to pray that God's blessing comes into your life. And I felt like, you know, you are my parish family, and we are a family together, but your first priority is your own family yourself. And I was feeling that way myself at the time. I said, you know what? I occasionally pray for my family. I always ask God to bless them, but not in any kind of concerted way. And so I was going to take that up. And so I asked them if they could all send a picture of all their kids and grandkids. And I was thinking at the time, individual pictures. Well, that became a little bit of a hard task to undertake. So the whole project got put on pause to the point where I kind of forgot about it. Well, I opened up my presents yesterday, and I'll show you one of them here. I brought it with me. Well, I kind of forgot about my ask. They didn't. So that's all my brothers and sisters and their families. And in fact, that's Joey. And my younger sister, Mary Jo, still has to get her picture to us here. But this is everybody, all my brothers and sisters, their children, and even some of their grandchildren are in here as well. So I've decided that I'm not just going to throw a prayer here and there, but I'm going to actually go full on prayer, fasting, novenas, whatever way God sets on my heart. But I'm hanging this in my my private chapel. And I encourage you to do the same. You know, if you have brothers and sisters in their families, even cousins, people that you feel are close to you, that you pray for them. You know, family gatherings for a lot of people were tough yesterday, because we're being divided so much. And the world is, I call it indoctrinating us into going a different way than the way of our Lord. And I think it's actually ramped up a lot in the last 10 years. For sure in the last 6 years with the decision to allow same-sex marriage. And just even from that time, it's just, you know, we feel like we're punch drunk sometimes with everything that the world is advocating that goes directly against the will of God. And if our brothers and sisters, our nieces and nephews, our cousins aren't careful, if they're not nearer to God, you know, they can be swept up in this. And then what happens when you have a family gathering is it can be tough. You can maybe get into discussions that become arguments, and there's division. This is all the devil's plan, to get us all divided. Well, we need to be uniters, all right? So let's look back again to what does it mean to be signum qui contradictor, to be a sign of contradiction. And I found a great explanation by Bishop Conley, of Nebraska. And I want to share it with you today. And it goes like this. G.K. Chesterton says, each generation is converted by the saint who contradicts it the most. We are called to be disciples of all nations, to proclaim the gospel and bring the world to Jesus Christ. The world sorely needs Christ. It's clear and becoming clearer every day that our culture is characterized by relativistic consumer values and a profound crisis of real meaning. It's becoming clear that we do not live in an era defined by Christian virtue or a true sense of human dignity. If we are going to make disciples in the stark, technocratic, lonely culture of American public life, we need to become signs of contradiction. In today's world, that means that we are called to embrace
What the world rejects, friendship, beauty, goodness, truth, weakness, suffering, joy, and hope. If we are going to become the saints of this moment, it will be because we embrace the reality of human life, living fully and freely, because of the hope that we have in Jesus Christ. Becoming a sign of contradiction is not the same as becoming contrarian. Evangelization is not a war with the world, nor does becoming a sign of contradiction mean withdrawing from the world. The world is already mired in conflict and fractured and atomized. Becoming a sign of contradiction means witnessing to something more delightful, more profound, and more meaningful than what our world offers. Evangelization is an invitation expressed in love to encounter, love, and serve the living God. Evangelization is a witness to the real peace, joy, and hope of life in Jesus Christ. So many times yesterday, I found myself trailing off in an area I shouldn't have. So, like, for instance, I think that the current virus that we have, Omicron, it looks like the science is coming in that it's a cold and it's spreading fast. And okay, this is where I'm at right now, but we don't have enough science yet, is that I said, praise God. Then we're all going to get hit with it, and it's going to be a cold, and then we're all going to get the antibodies, and it's going to do what a virus is supposed to do. It weakens so that it doesn't kill its host so it can survive. We learned all this in the beginning of the virus here. But not everybody's there. And I started to talk about that yesterday, and I went, oh, wait a minute, how about those Packers? So I changed the topic. I didn't want to get in any kind of conflict with any of my brothers and sisters and nieces and nephews. We had a glorious day together. And for the day, we laid off of controversial issues. We just celebrated being a family together. I think our first move in being that sign of contradiction is to get down on our knees and pray. But I'm talking pray fervently. Add fasting. Fasting gives the underdog the victory. Novenas, more concerted effort in praying, for sure. But we have to be purveyors of truth with love. And we have to avoid at all costs the cool kids phenomenon. You know, that we found something and that makes us an elite class. You know, we're the cool kids. I've talked about this before. You know, for whatever reason, when I was growing up and I was a kid, I would see the cool kids congregate on different parts of the playground and count themselves as cool. I was nauseated. I was angry. How dare you? And I made a vow early on, I think I was this high, that I would never do that because it's repugnant that they're doing that. And so it is with us, with our Catholic faith. We can't be looking down our nose at anybody. We have to offer our open arms, our smiles that say, I love you, I care about you, and no, I don't think I'm better than you. I think I found something, and it's incredible. And it's made all the difference in my life. Do you see the joy in my smile? The words that I offer? Do you see the difference? That's what being a sign of contradiction means. We're different than the world. The world is filled with gloom and hatred and depression. We're filled with joy. We're filled with love and hope. Oh, it's a big word, hope. We're filled with hope that for those who want to cling to the Lord, life is filled with a fire that burns bright within us and gives us a desire to cry out, as we heard in our first reading, Abba, Father. Now, I look more closely at that word, Abba. I've always said, oh, it's like Daddy, Papa. Yeah? I've done a little bit more research. It is, but not like a child says it. More like what an adult says it. Dad, are you proud of me? I love you, Dad. I thank you, Dad, for all you've done for me, Dad. You see what I'm saying there? Dad, that kind of relationship. I was looking around at my brothers and sisters and watching them look onto their children and grandchildren with such pride and such love. But then to have the grandchildren and grandchildren look back to them as if to say, are you proud of me, Dad? Thanks for all you're doing, Dad. And Mom. But in this context, we're talking about God the Father. Do you see? We're called to evangelize. We got to be attractive. And that means we love almost obnoxiously. Almost obnoxiously. Because see, that's wholly different than the world. You will be a sign of contradiction. You will be a source of God's grace. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Thank you. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary,
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary,
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary,
Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Saint Michael the Archangel.